first 10 plus 10, 20.
I have a 7-year-old. I talk to my daughter a lot about how math, just like most things, you learn through practice.
What does a mistake mean when you make a mistake?
Well, that it's better to make a mistake because then you learn from your mistakes.
Kids can pick up on worries and anxiety from those around them. It can be their teachers in the classroom or their parents who say things like, I'm not good at math, or I'm just not a math person, or we're not math people. A lot of what we do here at Barnard College is based on the idea that it's not just what you know. Your anxieties, your motivation really matters. Math anxiety is a fear or apprehension around math. Whether it's seeing numbers in a textbook and getting nervous, to being worried when you calculate a dinner bill and the tip and all your friends are looking on.
One.
Researchers, teachers thought math anxiety wasn't really something that developed until middle or high school. But my research team and I have shown that as early as first grade, at the start of formal schooling, some kids are really worried about doing math.
Math anxiety ultimately creates a leaky pipeline in STEM fields.
We know that STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math fields are growing at a rapid rate. And if kids are anxious and stay away from math, we're missing a whole population of young women, young men, who would have the opportunity to excel in these areas and change the world.
I see some math anxiety in some of the students who I have here at Barnard. Then I say, you know, the only way to get good at it is just keep practicing.
One of the tools that exists is an app called Bedtime Math, which my colleagues and I studied. We were interested in whether giving parents access to the opportunity to read fun stories and do short math problems with your kids could actually improve their child's math achievement.
This one is called Karate Chop.
Hiya. We worked with a large Midwestern school district, and we randomly assigned families to either be part of our bedtime math group or they did bedtime reading instead. By the end of our study, kids whose parents were anxious about math were about 5 months behind in math in school compared to kids whose parents weren't anxious. But when these kids whose parents were anxious did bedtime math with their parents, we got rid of that gap.
If I could wave a magic wand, I would encourage parents to just stop saying, I'm not a math person. It creates this sense of identity around being good or being bad at math.
What's right in between 4 and 6?
Instead of reading 2 books at night with your child, read 1 book and then do the bedtime math app for those other 5 to 10 minutes. And then you've got the complete package of the languages you'll need for the rest of your life.
5, very good.
Math is all around us. It's around us with angles and shapes. When you do a puzzle, talking about how pieces fit together, going in New York City and thinking about the grids of the streets, how they form, lines come together, how different streets are perpendicular or parallel. This is all math. I think we often think that math is really situated to the textbook, to adding numbers or times tables, but our whole world is based up of symbols and relationships, and teaching kids that it's really interesting and fun and they do math all the time is a great way to get them excited about the subject.